Good afternoon everyone. Today's topic is MailChimp and Mantle. The introduction to MailChimp and Mantle. The Humility Kingdom. We pronounce it as Humility. So if you are curious to know what Humility means, is that if we talk about the family of monkeys, so this is the super name given to the all from which all monkeys have been derived. This is the scientific name for all, like you can say, the monkey community. So let's start. This is our agenda today. The first thing is understanding MailChimp. Then we'll be having the first phase of the workshop, that is demonstrating MailChimp. Then we'll be understanding a bit about Mantle. Like this would be like very nominal details. Rest would be covered by Bharat. And then are the cousins Mantle and MailChimp. In this category, we'll basically differentiate between what all traits MailChimp and Mantle possess and how they are different. Okay, in the second phase we'll be demonstrating the functioning of the Mantle SDK, SCA Mantle, that we have used, and then the limitations of this SDK that Bharat will sort and how Bharat will sort them. And does anyone cares about these mutated monkeys? That means like who all peoples are using this currently and how well reputed it's in the market, and then we'll be concluding. So MailChimp. So what exactly MailChimp is? MailChimp is email marketing software. So email marketing software are those category of softwares which provide email facility for marketing sales purpose. So this software targets that particular area, and what it actually is, it is a bulk email service. By bulk email services, we mean like promotional offers. For example, like Flipkart says that like Big Billion Day is going to be announced. So these are certain type of notifications that have been delivered to a mass. The notification says same for all. So this is the use case of MailChimp. So and how do we achieve it? We create a list of listeners, a list to which the mail is being triggered. So so why MailChimp? So these are some of the traits that why MailChimp is popular. So more than 14 million people and business use MailChimp to send 1 billion emails every day. So that's quite a number. And so easy to use and packed with hundreds of features. It gives a marvelous UI through which you can manage all the services and can like very simply send the mails and perform every stuff very very cozily. So, and one of the features, it's provide brilliant analytics that what all mails have been delivered, how many were blocked, and every detail has been covered very correctly and very very informative. And so robust mobile functionality. This means that it also provides a mobile app, so handling and managing your MailChimp account is very simple. And along with this, it has many other features like integration with e-commerce, but those are all versions available in the paid version of the MailChimp, so we will not be covering that for now. So like the WS phase one, as I can see there is no laptop, so I'll be demonstrating it so you can just have a view how we do things here. So okay, the screen has been compacted, so that's why it's coming like this. So we have our templates, lists. So first of all, we'll go to lists. So this is the place where we add the listeners which will be receiving our email. For example, now I have already created a MailChimp workshop list. So I'll be like creating a new list to demonstrate it, how it is done. List name, workshop on the go, and from email it will be the default from email that that will be displayed when the email is been sent. So default from name, and use your mom.
So can I add in an anonymous email address?
Well, you can, since it's MailChimp. You have to just authenticate whether you have access to that email or not. So whatever email you provided, it will give an option of verify the email, the sender email. So it will send a code on that. You have to just put in on that and it will be verified.
So that is also an option, not a mandatory.
If you, take some other, for now, Noldus.com, suppose I sent from arpit@noldus.com, then I have to verify that mail. So I'll be triggering a mail that will give him a code which I have to enter, then only the mail will be sent.
Okay, and no reply thing, can we do that?
No reply in a sense?
So you set an anonymous email, okay?
Okay.
Okay, and if I want to reply on that email,
yeah.
So is there any options I can implement the no reply functionality? Like, do they provide something?
I didn't saw that functionality.
I mean, it just provides the whatever email we specify while for the sending list. Person can reply on that mail.
And what in case of anonymous email, okay, saying, so what will be the email address I'm getting the mail from? Where?
Okay, for that which? I said to bring the systems. Okay, for example, I can show one if I have.
In this, when you fill the form, you put your email, send me.
Yeah.
This is the sender email or.
I'll explain if I get the answer.
Is there any feature auto generate email whenever, as soon as I'm trying to send in a mail?
Let me answer one question, guys.
Just mentioning. Yeah, I tried it once. I even sent a mail to me from ID of Arpit.
Oh, that email is a sender email or some random email?
The email that we send it, that's the one.
Sender email.
Yeah.
From where the sender?
That you opened, that was from Arpit's ID.
That was from Arpit's ID.
Yeah. Open it up. Arpit@noldus.com reply to
reply to actually from now from Sahil Sani is the default name that I had been given.
So
the ID would be of arpit@noldus.com.
So this arpit@noldus.com, where it came from?
Actually, there is one thing. The emails that you don't verify, they either go into spam folder.
Okay.
Or either into the promotional folder. For example, I tried it once with Bharat Singh Mail. It went into the promotional email sector.
And what if I don't have a promotional tab in my inbox? And what if they are not of Gmails?
Okay, when I tried the same on my system, I got it in my mail since I don't have any categorization.
Have you tried apart from any other clients?
No.
Yahoo, Hotmail, something?
Well, I tried from Hotmail. A month before, and it worked.
Probably you won't get it in your inbox at least. We are not sure where it will be landed, but you will not get it in your inbox. That's
okay. So actually, it is showing that I have sent the mail, okay, and I didn't.
No, actually, then at the bottom you can see that there was one mailed by and signed by. You can see all this mailing list and stuff is there. If you go and see a normal,
Normal people won't be seeing this. Okay, so they'll just will be saying from, which is arpit@noldus.com, and reply to is the same. So is it security loopholes, or they are just mocking me actually?
It's how they have implemented it. So you can say it's a loophole, but I'm sure
MailChimp is working on a loophole. Are you saying so? Actually, they're like mocking me, and I guess like no one will be like under like comfortable with this.
Yes, that's.
So you can just send anything to anyone with my email address.
Yes.
Actually, Arpit, so this is not a security breach or something. That this is the functionality that provided by all mails. All mail providers.
That's correct.
Where they have option for set sender, any sender, because like earlier you said no reply email, no reply address something.com, no reply got an address of email. This means we just set any randomly email address from sender and send.
Actually, like, Gmail won't Gmail won't let you create no reply something or
contact. That's why. Every mail API, not only a MailChimp, other mail API if you see like SendGrid or other mail
API. That's an alternative for
I'm just asking, like, shouldn't be there a way to authenticate that if that's arpit@nautilus.com is like belongs to someone, or his or she like are allowing you to send the email on behalf of me? I'm just asking that.
Yeah, I mean, for now, as we can see, as I showed you, it allows you. So that would be a simple answer.
It's kind of dangerous, yeah, I guess.
It is actually dangerous, but it's interesting too.
So interesting, it seems to be interesting.
Both sides. Dangerous or some flexibility.
Now
I can send the email and
think that the loss flexibility.
This is a service which is already existing. So like, I mean, I can't, and they don't provide us any mechanism, like it's not open source. So I can't make any changes to it. I agree with you that what you are saying, that anyone can anonymously send an email through your ID, but that's what the service provides for now. And
so there must be possibly a way that we can disable. Or
yeah, you can. I think there is an option to unsubscribe or something.
File a case against.
Is there any traces of your account in the email? Like, are there any addresses or are there any key or something? Like, can you just...
He'll
be having pictures of his MailChimp account.
That is signed by...
This is signed by, as you can see, the signed
this
by...
This is just a name.
Can you reply back on this mail and see if it goes for it?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try this one.
So, let me reply and we'll check.
And I think they have also written something
as
a disclaimer there.
Yeah, I mean, MailChimp is also there at the bottom of it. The email was sent to... Why did I get this? I mean, this is all replaced dynamically in the content, and like this MailChimp comes along with it. So if you can check, I mean, like from my system it takes like 10 seconds, it will be sent after 10 seconds. So meanwhile... I've just kept it so that I can undo if I send some wrong email. So meanwhile, what I did, I just created a list. So now I'm not adding any contact to it right now. I just created a empty list, just named it, and means this was all details were present when I created the account. So what I did, I just named it and reminded people how they sign up to your list. I mean, how. Like, it's just a reminder. Okay, I'll be saving this list. One thing is that when I add any contact into the list, it's not reflected immediately. It will be placed inside that list in a while. Okay. So, let's do lists. List, let us. Workshop on the board.
Yes.
See, I've got the mail actually.
But there would be something. I mean, like, it would be signed by MailChimp, but something would be there that it will differentiate it with, the actual mail that you send. I think.
Yeah, but a simple sa padna hai iska. Jab mail aaye MailChimp ke through, to niche jo metadata hai, usme MailChimp ka proper hai.
In what's the ID for that? Like everyone
shown under the jacket with more detail होती है, IP भी होती है. But normal people जब देखते हैं,
all the people that do some. I'll add my money so that I can see the So this is the email address that I'm adding. Mentioning the credentials. And I click this. This person gave me the permission to email them. And I'll be subscribing it. So meanwhile, this contact, like right now, as I told, I mean, can I come here? Okay, now it's like showing it, but yesterday I was trying it. It was like taking a minute to do it. Okay, now maybe my email ID is been already been verified, so it did it instantly. So now I'll be making a template. So three things. First, we make a list, then we make a template to which the actual content that would be sent in a mail, and then in the third thing is the campaign where we integrate everything and we send the mail. And it's not necessary to first create a list and template. You can like do it while the campaign process is going on. So okay, now I've made a template, and making a template in it is very easy. I mean, like, I don't like this view. It's so here you have things like text. It's just drag and drop. So you have, you get options in it. You can either drag drop the content, or you can just paste in the HTML content directly. Okay, so I mean, like, if you want to see it, I can show it how it works. Like, I go to, I mean, templates, I create a template. So it gives me an option. I need to take one basic. Basic means the category of drag and drops, and then I have themes. That these are the like already built themes, like as I sent once to Pranjat, the pumpkin slayer, about the pumpkin slayer. And then this one is code your own. You have to just select it, paste your code in there, and it works. I'll be demonstrating it later. For now, I'll be taking my basic. So since I've already made one, I'll be taking this template. This is a template. I'll just drag and drop things. So like this is the box text, this is an image, and it's very easy to upload an image. You have to just select the image. You just select an image box, image, and suppose here, and then you can browse it from your system and you can use it. And since I don't want it now, so I'll just go over it. This one is for moving the stuff now, and this is to edit, and this is of course to delete, since we see a trash out there. So like, and we can also add buttons. So it gives an option that you can drag a button, and then you can see that it gives you an option to place in the URL that will be directed to. Okay, now since it's very simple to fabricate a template. So now we have our list that has one contact, that is me. We have our template, and now we switch to the campaign. And so and this is the entire process how the Noldus newsletters are sent. So this is the same process. Okay, so let's create a campaign. So I'm selecting a regular campaign. This is, I don't want unnecessary customizations. So I'll be choosing a list as a workshop on the go. Then entire list I've selected. Then next step setup. Campaign name, my campaign. Then email subject, what email, like let's put in testing 123. Okay, and this is from name that I've selected. If I'll not fill it will be blank and just show the email ID out there. So from email address is this. If suppose I write ABC something, So there comes an option to verify it. Basically, generally there is an option to. I don't know why it's not there right now. So like this will be the from email address and this is the tracking list. As I so said, it gives an brilliant way to like track what all mails have been sent. So and this would be if I mean like social media connection and all. I mean like it's a whole lot of things that you can do with it. So next step, I'll be proceeding to the next step. There I'll be seeing these are the templates. As I said, you can either create the template on the go or you can select it since it's like easy to manage. So I mean like I'll be selecting this template. Okay. I select this one. Now confirming it. I have to see this. This would be the subject line and all. Since all the since our tech that I have a list, I have a subject, and everything is being set up. And it's an HTML email. It means that I mean, like it's like two categories of that. It's like plain text or HTML. So,
so
preferred category is HTML email.
There you can edit the replies, right? So you can edit whether you need a reply or not.
I'll look into it.
Just a
the conversation to manage replies, create a conversation field, personalize to field.
Okay.
I mean, these are like the merge values that are, I mean, these are the replacement values. I mean, Bharat will be explaining it better.
Okay.
Okay. I mean, like, right now I'm doing one by one, like, on the big screen, there is an option that all of them are present. So now I'm just sending it. So send now ready to do it. Let's see whether I filled all credentials correctly or not.
This delay is intended actually because MailChimp does not take any delay, right?
I think it's generally instant platforms. Okay, I got it. Just took just a second, like something I'll refresh it once. So here I have my mail. It's very pathetic view. So hope you enjoyed my wedding. Payback time now. I'll soon be sending the receipts of the wedding food plate through MailChimp, which is a cousin of this wedding is wrong, cousin of MailChimp, and I used to send transactional emails. So I have added a link here which like takes me to Paytm for the payment work. So this is basically how MailChimp works. It's and since this is a bulk message, since we don't have any like particular details of any person being added into it, so it's like it's an email that can be delivered to everyone. So it comes under the category of bulk emails, and that is which is implemented using MailChimp. So let's get back to our slide. Yeah. This is the first meal of the workshop. Now, what is Mendel? Now, Mendel is a transactional email. Now, this is a keyword here. Built by MailChimp, it's a powerful delivery system and it serves the purpose of one-to-one e-commerce deliveries. For example, now promotional emails you can get that can be given in bulk. But suppose you purchase a product, you purchase a phone. So for that, you are the only person that will be getting the invoice for it or the receipt for it. So for that purpose, where one-to-one email are sent on basis of some action or reaction, those are handled by Mendel, which is a paid feature being provided by MailChimp. So here we don't have any contact lists, and we manage the contacts one by one. For example, the contacts can be present in our database, or like we can manually add them. Like for example, the answer I'll be showing, that it's a very basic application which just like puts in the recipient's name, and so that's what Mantle is. And so what a transaction is, I'll be skipping this for now. Like since Bharat will be exploring more on Mantle, so he'll be explaining. So basically transactional email is like, you can say one-to-one emails. For now you can understand by this. So now why Mantle? Why do we use Mantle? So it's like, it is globally distributed infrastructure. So it has like excellent servers being placed around the world, which gives a like wonderful performance. And then we have multiple domains per account. It means that if we have a Mantle account with us, then we can like open as many link as many domains with it, and we can provide it an API key. That API key is like actually a key. I mean, so that's what you need to actually send an email. Like that's what the thing is. I mean, like through which your mail SDK or whatever you are directly firing an API, so through that API key it's been referenced to through which account or through which domain the things should be sent. Okay, so unlike multiple domains for account, in-depth analytics, wonderful analytics, and then templates and dynamic content. So and templates and dynamic content, it means that you can build templates in Mantle too. And how is it? It is more dynamic than will be explained by Bharat. And then email, amazing email tracking facilities. So now, so are MailChimp and Mantle, are they cousins? So what do you think? I mean, they are. I mean, they are slightly different.
They seems like father and son.
Yeah, it can be said. I mean, so this slide is basically so that you can like just think for a minute about the differences that you face between both of them. So the first one was that MailChimp is used for bulk emails and Mantle is used for the transactional emails. Second is we have a list for MailChimp, and for Mantle we don't have a list. We assign contact one by one, that what information is to be sent.
But you don't buy your cousins, right?
So now phase two. Before going to phase two, let's understand how we, since Mantle is a product of MailChimp, the Mantle account is linked with our MailChimp account. So let's see how things work here. We go to accounts. We go on the transaction tab. And inside that we see Mantle, like since I have linked it with Mantle, so it's giving me like this. Otherwise it would be like M would be placed in the center and it would be written just connect to Mantle, or some text would be written. So I'm like launching the Mantle. So here it is, our Mantle. It will be explained by Bharat. So I'll be like, it's just the dashboard. So in the in the second phase of my workshop, I'll be demonstrating you about an SDK. I'll be like referring it something. Yeah, it's Scamantle. As you can see, Scamantle. So this is a wonderful API. I mean, it's like SDK. It's very flexible and it provides. It's very easy to use. And so we'll be now discussing what we are regarding the API that we are using. The actual API, we can abstract it for now because the API would be covered by Bharat. So all that portion that we are using, not the entire, actually there are like around 20 options of sending different categories of mails. So this one is the most common one, where we have a template over MailChimp or Mantle, and we just place in, or like the paste the content on the emails and send it directly. So that's how the things are done here.
isn't it the same SDK which have some like missing yes. APIs, right?
Yes, and that's I mean like with moving further I'll be discussing that too. So in it, first we have to see that MBAS. Now here we have list of changes, so I've just named it something like that. So basically the idea is we'll be having, I'll explain it with the reference over template. If I go here and now this template I have created using, as you can see, the HTML code. I just created the template for the HTML, just deleted all the HTML that was present like before, and I just pasted my HTML there, and the things come like this. So as Bharat corrected me today, these are called merge tags. So now first name, last name, these are the keys. These are the keys to which the value which will be sent by our SDK will paste on. So like these can be treated as dynamic places. I mean like say for same template, if I send the credentials to be Sahil, first name is Sahil, second name is Sahani, that will be pasted like that. Similarly for like any name like Salman Khan or anything. So like these are the items, item 1, thrice 1, item 2. So basically this is the receipt of things that were eaten by Arpit, Bhavya sir and Anubhav on my sir's wedding. So these are the three things, and then we have the total amount of the bill.
But and if I have a list of items, right, then how will I iterate?
Let me complete please. You are having like spot on, the question is spot on. We'll be like, and so let's and
you're just saying that to deter me from asking another question.
No. Actually, the thing is that we have divided our portion. So if I'll speak, he'll kill me. Nothing else. So now, as you can see, here's skull image URL. This is actually an image URL that I'll be directly sending from my email. And I've used one, it's not a trick, just a shortcut for this. So like these are the list of changes. Now, since it's an SDK, it provides a wonderful, I mean awesome case classes in which I have to just paste in the things and everything is marshaled and marshaled, things goes on and it is finally converted into API which is sent further, but I'll be abstracting that for now. That's, I mean like a bit complex. So now in the MBARS, as you can see that there was first name, last name, and we have item 1 and item 2, their price. So these are all the keys, and corresponding to that is the value that will be replaced there. Okay, so now since I may have different details for different people, so it's like the list of changes for Arpit. So example, the mail that will be sent to Arpit, that will that will contain these details. Okay, so now since I'm trying all these things on my my account, okay, now list of changes are being specified. Now these are the default values. Default values means that in case a merge tag for that value is not present, it will be replaced by the default value which I am providing by now. That's, I have kept NA for this, and default names are Sahil Sahani since I went to the wedding. And so this is the skull image URL. So one thing is that since the skull image URL and tongue face image URL were common for all the three templates, so I have kept it in default values so that I don't have to repeat it along with each list. So that can be taken as a shortcut. I don't know if it's a good practice or not.
But you are giving a URL for an image which is online, right?
Yeah, online.
If I want to provide a URL, okay, for the local
image. You can't do that. You have to first put the images on S3 or I mean like anywhere, so that you can obtain a, I mean like URL for that, and we can just
can you upload images on Mendel and then
provide? Yes. Actually, Mailchimp can store images in itself, and you can
get the links from there.
So it's not really required that you have a.
I think some images are also 64-bit encoding images. Okay, we can also put that images.
Yeah, it gives an option. Like if you can see the API, the last. Thing in the API comes for that, for putting in the six that as you said, encrypted images. Now, Bhavya, to answer you, Wallace saw that three plates were there. That image was not included dynamically, so that was being pasted into the template itself.
That is another thing, but I just you are trying to do a dynamic.
You can either upload the images or you can just paste them. I just wanted to show that how you can. Like that put in the common or you can put in the common data into the like default values, and so this is the main part where we populate our body. That is the major part of the API is filled here. Now as you can see in send message, there are like many things which you can personalize it, but I have made the data with the minimum requirements that can send the things. Now you can have a look at API, it's very well documented, and you can include the features that you want. And regarding the images, as you can see here in the last, it gives an option to attach image also. There's a case class for that. So now we'll be seeing what the subject is, workshop mails, and it would be sent C. And one more thing. Now for sending emails through Mendel, one thing is very important, that you need to have a registered domain. By registered domain, first of all, it's a three-step process. You have to include one DKIM. These are some TXT and CNAME records, like Vikas server did. Last night he added records for me, so that's why I'm able to use noldus.in domain name. Any other email ID except this domain name will not be sent. Okay, so basically we just since GoDaddy is our DNS provider, we just went into it and added some CNAMEs and TXT records. So this is our email ID from which the mail would be sent. Now this is the from name. It's optional to keep. You can, if you don't want to include it, just keep it a blank, like as I've done for HTML, empty string. Now this is the to list. Now this is very important. Now this to list includes the person is the address, and then none. It's like it's an additional option. I actually didn't understand the use of it. So it's like the option whether you want to send this email as a CC or a BCC, and or CC, BCC or 2. Okay. So I've added like 3 emails right here. I'll be sending. This means that this email will be sent to these 3 email IDs with respective. Whether it's a CC, BCC, that can be customized. Now this is the BCC address, tracking domain, this all the stuff I had to include because they were not optional. So I have just left them empty strings. And then we have the global merge wires where we'll be putting in our default data. And then we have the merge wires. So how these merge wires work. Now since we want to distinguish that, we have added that mail would be sent to these three email IDs. But what content would be sent to its credentials, so I can see it is whiskey, its price, then participant, parlay, and all that. And amount, calculate yourself because Mailchimp doesn't provide arithmetic capability. So I'd as you can see, the images are being placed here, the URLs are being substituted. Okay, now. Now Hotmail, I think Hotmail was the credential for Bhavya sir. So you can see Bhavya sir, we had a salad, salad, veg biryani, brownie, ice cream, good stuff. And this, now this one is the one with no credential. So Sahil Sani, NA.
It's the amount calculated.
I mean, basically the purpose was that it doesn't provide any arithmetic capabilities. So now I'll be finishing off. Phase 2 is over. Now, where the SDK labs, the question that Sir asked. What if we want to add looping construct? Like, instead of defining the dishes like dish 1, price 1, dish 2, price 2, why can't we apply a looping construct on it? So that's what, where the SDK lags, and that's why we removed the SDK from our project and implemented what Bharat will be explaining in the next session. And we can see, anyone who cares about these mutated monkeys? I mean, like, who all cares about this? So Noldus hears about it. We send our email templates, the newsletters via this amazing service of MailChimp. Then Shopify, Twitter, SurveyMonkey. I mean, like, these are all the partners which I have collaborated with to perform a brilliant e-commerce platform. And any alternatives? There are like many alternatives, but what I read the most about was that it provides like very easy to use template management system. So it's been used. Basically, it was, I'll be giving a brief history. It was basically designed to like to compete with the Amazon SES, and then it was a standalone project and was being merged in to the Mendel to the MailChimp. And now these are my references. Any questions?
Well,